We're excavating down. We've taken the excavation all the way down to the chalk level that lays underneath the site area. But before we do that, we had to do a few special jobs. We've had to put temporary support work all the way around the top of our basement walls, and that stops the walls folding in before we've got the rest of the concrete structure built around it. Once that temporary support was in, we then drilled wells 16 metres deep down into the chalk again, and that is to help to keep the groundwater down while we're digging down, because obviously groundwater in an excavation with the guys working is just not a very good mix. So to make sure we deliver a safe, good quality job, we need to keep the water out. So at the moment we're constantly pumping the water down to keep the water out. Once the reinforcing steel's tied, we have to fill the hole back up with concrete. So as with lots of projects, we spend a long time digging down, trying to get the hole dug out faster, and now we're trying to fill it up just as quick again the other way around again. So we spent a long time going down, and now we're trying to get it back up again. So once all the steel is fixed, we'll then fill that back up with concrete again. Now we need about 1900 cubic meters of concrete to put in there, so that's a lot of concrete. And behind us you'll see we'll have a series of large concrete pumps, and those concrete pumps will be pumping the concrete straight from the lorry straight down, and then there'll be crews down at the bottom of the hole, and they'll be then placing that from the hoses and then we'll be filling that up. So the concrete that we're going to pour into the hole, concrete roughly weighs about, say, something like 2 tonnes per metre cubed. We've got about 1,900 cubic metres to go in there. There's about 3,800 tonnes of concrete. Once the concrete's poured, there isn't any room for error at all. We spent a great deal of time making sure the holding down bolts that we have down there have a 0 millimetre tolerance. They have to be in exactly in the right place. So we have no room for error whatsoever. So once we start pouring concrete, that's it. You've got to finish. You can't stop.